Stewie, I...
Brian, you are blocked.
Come on, you guys, relax. Let's have a fun night. We haven't done anything as a family since we sat courtside at that NBA game.
You okay? You guys okay?
Great seats.
Yeah, it's a whole different game when you sit down here.
Now return to Major League Baseball with one distractingly ugly guy behind home plate.
It's 2-2 in the bottom of the sixth, and I just can't get my eyes off that man with the tall head.
It's quite a game, but man, that guy is ugly.
I'll say, Gary, what's the count?
No idea, Bill, but you know that guy hasn't blinked this entire game? Just a dead-eyed idiot out on a Thursday afternoon.
Yep, and the longer I watch him, the more I wonder if he's there by himself.
I think you're onto something there. That seat next to him's been empty for hours.
Right you are, Gary. I'm gonna see if I can hit him with my apple. Ow, kinda short-armed it.
Oh, I'll get to the bottom of this. Take care, Donna.
The NFL experience. That sounds cool.
Kid, you're the best. Sign with me and you're gonna make millions.
Griffin, get out there!
Ow!
It's his knee.
Doc!
You'll never play football again.
Too bad, kid.
You was gonna buy me a house!
Now I have headaches. I'm gonna save my brain for science.
You guys, look! It's Golden State Warriors star, Steph Curry! Oh my God, Steph, I'm such a big fan!
Thanks, it's nice to meet you.
Hey, I know we just met, but can I sit on your lap during your next post-game press conference?
Sure, I don't see why not. This is exciting for the whole Bay Area, to be just four games away from the championship.
Dad, I duked.
The other team's not just gonna go away, though. We've gotta stay focused, keep doing what we've been doing.
Fat lady! Dad, a fat lady!
Yeah, I see her, Peter.
Make her go.
That's not how we talk to people.
Make her go.
I'll leave.
Yay, I'm learning bad lessons. Oh, crap.
Easy there. Hey, it's Thanksgiving. Shouldn't you be in Detroit losing a football game right now?
Come on, Stewie, check your damn messages. God. That must be where they do the deed. I hope it's at least peaceful and humane.
Vic!
Oh, boy.
And Eli Manning!
Oh, I didn't know that about Eli Manning.
Oh, yeah. I'm a real idiot psychopath.
We now return to Lady and the Tramp and Michael Vick.
All right, I'm ready. Come on. Good game, everybody. Yeah. Come on, good game. Let's get out there. Let's do it. Yeah, yeah. 110%, everybody. 110%, yeah? Come on, let's go. Let's go. Good game.
Ready. Blue 20. Blue 20. Hot, hot. Griffin, let go.
Let's tell us, Griffin. It's almost time for kickoff.
Well, I guess we got to start without him.
What do you think, eh? I got this for doing that car dealership ad. All right, enough messing around, huh? Let's play this game. Let's play some football.
Griffin, I'm getting really tired of your cocky attitude. How many times have I told you? No showboating.
Relax, Tom. I'm just having a little fun. I got it under control.
Okay, 28, Z right, pitch left. On one, on one. Ready, break.
Ready, 354, 354. Sit, hut, hut.
There might be some hope for this guy after all.
Yeah!
Damn it, Griffin! I said no showboating!
This calls for a victory tune! Now, a woman who'll kiss on a very first date is usually a hussy. And a woman who'll kiss on a second time out is anything but fussy. But a woman who'll wait till a third time around, head in the clouds, feet on the ground, she's the girl he's glad he's found. She's his shaboopy, 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 shaboopy.
The girl who's hard to get.
Shaboopy, shaboopy, shaboopy.
But you can win her yet.
Walk her once just to raise the curtain. Walk around twice and you make for certain. Once more in a flower garden, she will never get...
It is. Were the paramedics able to resuscitate Lamar Odom?
They're still working on it.
He's tall, get it?
Okay, Chris, your mom and I want to help you get out some of that aggression, so I thought you and me could huck rotten apples at passing cars.
Oh, I didn't know we had brown apple in the forecast. Well, we needed it.
Wow, can I have a turn?
Hey, which one of you threw that apple at my car?
He did it. He dragged me out here. I wanted to be in school, sir.
Where'd you get a cannon like that, kid?
I work out my right arm 3 times a day.
Free weights?
No, mostly JPEGs of Helen Hunt on my hard drive.
Well, I'm Coach Doyle, and I head up the baseball team at James Woods High.
What fake class did I also make you teach? Driver's Ed, right?
No, woodshop.
Ah, that was my second guess.
Tell me, son, how would you like to pitch for the high school team?
Baseball's the sport people play while eating, right?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes I even watch a whole blacklist.
Well, I don't know. I've never played baseball before.
Oh, come on, Chris, you gotta do it. If you don't, you'll regret it. Just like Jesus' friend, Evan, who bailed on the Last Supper.
Aw, they did a painting? I would have gone if I knew they were going to do a painting.
Just like I did in my 1980s crime series, Gary Ratowski, hockey cop.
Give me that purse.
Hey, criminal. Puck you. Get the puck out of my neighborhood. Go puck yourself. Uh-oh, here come the real cops.
Hockey cop, not a cop.
Have your attention, please. We've reached that part of the evening when our house champion takes on all challengers. Any of you lovely ladies like to try your hand in the ring?
Hey, Lois, what do you think? You want to fight that lady's boobs?
What? No, I'm not fighting anyone.
Oh. Well, good thing I made this plaster mold of your hand and forearm. Hey, buddy, over here.
I see a woman's hand and forearm at table 8.
Damn it, Peter.
Please, Lois, come on. You got to fight it.
Come on, Lois, get in there. Take her down. It'll be awesome.
I'd really like to see that.
All right. If it'll shut you all up, I'll do it. All right, so how does this work? We gonna pretend to hit each other for a while, then maybe kiss a little, huh? I'm terrible. Hey, watch it. That was pretty hard.
No, it wasn't. Try this one.
Stop that, young lady. I'm just out here for fun.
Yeah, punch each other, you whores!
Okay, you little bitch, that's it! You wanna f*** with me? Let's go! No matter what you do for the rest of your life, you'll always be garbage.
Oh my God, I didn't know Lois had that in her.
Hey, is that your wife?
You bet that's my wife.
Well, I gotta say, she's a natural. You know, she could make some serious money as a professional.
Wow, you really think so?
Oh, sure. Women's boxing is a rapidly growing part of the field. You should consider your wife competing for a belt.
Well, she did look like she knew what she was doing up there.
Think about it. Here's my card.
What can I say? I really like watching her box.
That means two things.
Nothing but net. Hi, I'm Magic Johnson with a few tips on blowing up the Death Star. First off, never forget your objective. There gonna be so many folks coming at you to slow you down, you might feel like you got a bullseye on your head. No, but they will be trying to kill you. Also, don't forget you have teammates out there watching your back. Unless you've been messing around with their wife or girlfriend. No, but they will be there to help you. Lastly, you want to make sure you step back and take cover after you sink that bucket, because that sky gonna light up like the 4th of July. No, but there will be a large explosion.
But I would do everything I could to make my now female father happy. Practices were intense.
I feel like you skipped over a very big story point right there.
My father was a World War II vet, so he used to make me reenact the D-Day landing with tennis ball machines. But the work paid off. I got invited to the first U.S. Open, which at the time was called the U.S. Now Open. There, I met the player who would become my arch rival, Sweden's Hed Berntsen. He'd bring his personal chef to every match, which was very distracting. Ah! What the hell?
Boogie boogie, meatball throwy.
Come on, this can't be legal. What are you, blind?
Serve ball!
I was the bad boy of tennis, and my unconventional style of play changed the game. Before I came along, tennis was so safe, it was customary to hit a six-handed backhand. I pioneered the one-handed backhand. And eventually, the no-handed backhand.
Quagmire, I love your backhand!
That sounds like a backhanded compliment. I made it to Wimbledon and got to play in front of a queen, Freddie Mercury. I altered my 40-bounce routine just for him. It was an honor playing for Freddie on grass that day. He later died. The doctor said it was asphalt. By the 1980s, things were starting to unravel.
Damn it!
My temper on the court was increasingly an issue.
Out.
Are you serious? You cannot be serious! I had a hard time telling if people were serious.
I spilled spot remover on my dog, and now he's gone.
Are you serious? I became famous for smashing rackets when things didn't go my way. Of course, back then, we didn't have multiple rackets, so I was forced to play with it. Ultimately, my career ended when I developed the yips. And in 2001, at the U.S. Open, my first serve hit a plane, causing it to go tragically off course and hit a building. Everyone blamed the Muslims. My second serve was no better.
Hey, Lois, congrats on winning that boxing match last night. I saw your picture in the Daily Growl.
Brian, the Daily Growl is not a real paper.
What? Yeah, it is. I like that sound.
Mom, since when are you a boxer?
I'm not, honey. Honestly, I don't know what came over me last night. It was just one of those crazy things that sort of happened after a few drinks.
Morning, everyone. Morning, champ. You feeling loose today?
Peter, what are you doing? What is all this?
I'm a fight promoter now, and I got you another fight. You're boxing tonight at the Quahog Civic Center.
Are you out of your mind? No, Peter, that was a one-time thing, all right? I am not a boxer, and I'm not fighting anyone else, and that's final.
All right, how about this then? I'll take you somewhere real fancy and romantic for dinner, just the two of us, and in return, I get to try and convince you to fight.
Well, going out for dinner would be nice, but I'm not changing my mind. Oh, gosh, I can't wait to see this fancy restaurant.
Oh, you're gonna love it, Lois. Here, put on these special eating gloves I bought you.
Why do I need to wear gloves to eat in a fancy restaurant?
Because it's so fancy that... You know what? I'm tired of this. I booked you a boxing match.
Son of a bitch! Damn it, Peter! I told you I don't want to be a boxer! Who the hell do you think you are?
There you go. Use that anger. Hey, remember when I said I think it's hot when you wear a sports bra and gym shorts underneath your dress?
Yeah?
Now put these shoes on.
Stop it, you jackass! I told you I'm not fighting! I'm sorry. There's been a terrible mistake. My idiot husband here booked this match without my knowledge.
She's from the Ukraine, Lois. She doesn't speak English.
All right. Menyshkoda probakhta, tam mishtrayu.
She's from the other part of the Ukraine. It's a different dialect.
One, two, three.
Hey, what you doing down here, Lois? Aw, what's your matter? Mad at little old me? In your imagination, I've got long eyelashes.
One, two, three!
Did you know where the Ukraine was because of my globe?
No, I saw it in a book.
You knew. Because of my globe, you dick.
8, 9, 10, we have a winner!
Well, what do you think of that, Lois? You still mad at me now?
Peter, I feel great. I've never felt so in control.
I know the feeling. It's how I feel when I burp really loud in an underground parking structure to assert my dominance. Says the king.
You find something funny, Private Dancer? Dancer for money? Any old music will do?
Well, actually, yeah. Your last little back and forth there with Stewie, that whole queer thing, that was actually pretty funny.
Oh, God!
Ugh, that's gotta hurt worse than getting a birthday telegram from Zinedine Zidane.
Yes?
Bon anniversaire.
What's up, dudes?
Stewie, what the hell is all this?
Only the most manly thing ever. A little something called American football.
Is that a Michael Sam jersey?
Yep, two boy names. Doubly masculine.
Like George Michael?
Shut up!
Come on, Stewie, are you still hung up about that woman at the grocery store thinking you're a girl?
Elton John is another.
It has nothing to do with that, Brian. I just thought it'd be good to take up a sport. You know, like boys do.
You don't have to play football to prove you're a boy.
Barney Frank is yet another one.
Chris, please. Actually, you know what? Ricky Martin. There's a bunch of these. Anyway, they're not going to let you play football, Stewie. You're too little.
Oh, don't worry. I'm going to be bad news for the other team. And nobody likes bad news. Except for Larry, the self-loathing idiot.
Larry, I'm afraid you only have 3 months to live.
Wow, so these are the wife beaters of tomorrow. Which team is Stewie gonna be on?
He's not gonna be on any team. He's just overcompensating because he was called a girl. But once he sees how big the other kids are, he'll back out.
Ooh, my shoes have 12 little heels.
They're cleats.
Okay, kids, let's start practice.
Yeah, football, boy stuff, hitting the shower, getting embarrassed, going home to shower.
Okay, Stewie, enough is enough. All right, let's get you out of here.
Yeah, you probably should get him out of there because he's just a little shrimp.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, look at him. My Tyler would kill him out there.
Okay, well, believe me, there's more to him than you'd think. Come on, Stewie.
You know, ballet is great exercise. Maybe you should put Shortstack in a tutu.
No, you know what, Stewie? Get the hell out on that field. And if you see that Tyler, take his knee out.
All right, let's do it. Football game. Then, reminder, showering at home.
Okay, I guess we'll see who's got the toughest kid here.
Yeah, I guess we will.
Hey!
Oopsie poopsie!
Aw.
Excuse me, Coach Herrera?
It's Herrera.
Okay, well, that's a lot of R's, but listen, I noticed you're not starting Stewie.
Oh, I can't put him in. I mean, he can come out for limp handshakes at the end of the game, but I can't play him. He's too little.
Little? Oh, like that car you drive over there? Let's see if it looks bigger when I throw a Sprite at it.
Well, it's not my car, but I don't care. I'm just a volunteer. All right, Griffin, get in there.
Come on, Stewie, give your dog something to post on Facebook. Something to post on Facebook. Let's go.
All right, and nobody's blocking.
Oh, my God, Stewie! Are you okay?
Back off. He may have a concussion.
A concussion?
You do me an honor, Lieutenant, but my dance card is full.
Hey, Stewie. How's our little concussion guy? Oh, my God. Can you see me?
Yeah, no, I'm fine. Is anybody gonna answer that telephone?
He keeps thinking the phone is ringing, Brian.
Well, at least he's talking again. I think that means he's getting better.
Is it day or night? I don't care. I just want to know.
Lois, answer the bloody phone!
No. We don't need Lois. Chris, pretend to answer the phone.
Hello? Okay, yes, one second. Mom, it's for you!
What? No, damn it, Chris. I'll take that. Hello, this is Brian Griffin. Actually, I already received the New York Times, and I always enjoy finishing the crossword puzzle.
You're bragging to nobody?
Phone's still ringing.
Crap, Chris, he's worse off than I thought. We have to do something.
Well, on TV, if somebody gets hit on the head, you hit them a second time, and that gets them back to normal.
No, Chris, this is very serious. You see, what a concussion is the impact of brain matter on the inside of the skull. That's why you sometimes hear this nonsense about, oh, let's just give him better helmets. But you can't make a helmet for the inside. Chris, are you crazy?
Shh, let's just let him sleep this off. Look how peaceful he is. I wonder what's going on in that little head of his.
The world looks mighty good to me. Cause Tootsie Rolls are all I see. Whatever it is I think I see becomes a Tootsie Roll to me.
He did Ross 20 years ago.
That's right, and that means he had you first, Lois. I'll always be Scottie Pippen to his Michael Jordan.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Jordan!
I'm Scottie Pippen.
He's also good. Why didn't they do Jordan last?
Alphabetical?
Oh, right. That's smart. You're smart.
Does your underwear have tags?
What? Mr. Jordan, you're gonna have to take your seat and stop asking people about their underwear.
Peter's so fat and stupid, Lamar Odom tried to bang him.
Fair ball! Run, Peter! Run it out!
Peter's brain.
Yeah, this is the muscle department. What the hell is he doing?
Apparently he's trying to sprint.
Sprint? He got winded walking to the plate! And he's been out in the blazing sun for 2 days. Has he had any water?
No, he told his wife there's juices in the hot dogs.
Well, I'm sorry. I got no choice but to call for a complete muscle failure.
Look, Dad's planking from like 8 years ago.
Is there a Neiman Marcus in Boston?
Peter, get up! Get up and run!
Run, Peter!
Come on, Dad!
We love you!
Copley Place. How far is that?
I ran like a champion that day, pushing through the pain of two torn hamstrings and a ruptured groin to leg out the hit at Fenway Park I had always dreamed of. But nobody noticed, because the account manager from B of A who was playing third base had a massive coronary trying to field my crappy little number. The hit was amazing, but what made it even better was that my family was there to share the moment with me. And on the car ride home, they put on a puppet show that made me laugh so hard, I crashed into a toll booth on the Mass Pike, totaling the car and breaking Lois's other leg. The casts kind of smell, so I won't let her sleep in the bedroom till they're off. But that's baseball.
All right, today we're going to play soccer.
Hey, do you think I could try to kick one?
No, you're all-time goalie.
I don't even want to be a part of this family anymore. Mag.
She'll be okay. Come on, we got to get back. The cameramen think we're taking Chris to soccer practice.
We're going to be late. Why won't you talk to me?
Go, Chris! Daddy loves you! I mean that in a platonic way. I'm married.
Handball. Penalty kick. Blue.
That's the 10th time today! Nice grab, Orca! Hey, get Moby Dick off the field before he burps up a license plate!
Hey, easy, fella. That's my kid. Now apologize.
Okay, I'm sorry your kid's a brain-dead, stinking blue cheese fat ass!
Oh, that's it!
Way to go, Dad!
Hey, you hit my mom!
No, I hit your dad.
Whoa, stand back. Give her some air.
You mean give him some air?
Call an ambulance. She's going into labor.
You mean he's going into labor? Whoops.
You know, she bought me something yesterday, but I'm not going to tell you what it is. I want you to guess. Just close your eyes.
Oh!
It's a soccer horn!
I know what it is!
Hey, Meg, where you going?
Are you kidding? The Olympic qualifiers are today. I'm competing.
In what?
I'm a bi-
Knew it.
Athlete.
Didn't know it.
If I win today, I'm going to the Olympics.
Why is this the first we're hearing about this?
It's not. God, how could you guys not know about this?
All right, I'm off to train for the Olympics.
See? I've been training since I was Lacey Chabert. So are you guys gonna come?
I don't know. The Yule Log channel just put on another log, and I really like it when the wood goes crack, crack, pop, crack, pop.
We all like that. Sorry, Meg.
That's okay. I guess I'll just drive there by myself.
again for coming, guys. It really means a lot to me.
Of course, honey. We wouldn't miss it. Plus, it's a good excuse to put on my winter coat and find items from last year still in the pocket. Ooh, sticky pennies, a rock-hard starburst, an appointment card for my next dental appointment. Meg, it is my duty as a bad father to prove that I can do anything my kids can do.
Okay, fine.
Here we go. Right, I think I'm getting the hang of it.
I have to say I'm very proud of Meg. Who knew she was good at something?
But her voiceovers were not reasonably priced, so they turned to me, a guy who sounds like Morgan Freeman, but is not, in fact, Morgan Freeman. My name is Josh Robert Thompson, and I perform for Scale.
Meg!
Shut up, Meg!
Wow, Meg is going to the Olympics!
Let's celebrate by burning our lips on vending machine hot chocolate.
Ow! Mine has whipped creams.
So it looks like the Griffins are going to the Winter Olympics in Korea.
Do you think there'll be a gag about the Jamaican bobsled team?
No, probably not.
No, because I was working on my exaggerated shiver. Yeah, man, it'd be cold.
Okay, yeah, maybe.
But let traveler's diarrhea keep me grounded.
No.
Well, then you're just handing this thing right to John Kruk.
Oh, my God, Brian, look.
Who is that?
Oh, that's Figures.
Your head is stunning.
Really? I get a lot of grief for it. Some people say it looks like a football.
Okay, I don't know what that is, but they're just jealous. Every one of them. Remember, nothing normal looks good.
Well, I have to say, you two are the best thing to happen to sports since the New York Knicks finally changed their name.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your two...
Wow, I can't believe I'm on a first-name basis with Tara Lipinski.
Now, refresh my memory. Is Tara the one who had the DUI?
That's Oksana Baiul.
Well, sounds like something Gandalf says at the foot of a mountain.
Oksana Baiul!
Tights over their thighs.
Stewie, it's not gonna fit.
Hey, we can do this. I worked with Garth Brooks, shirt and pants. Little secret? Garth wears leggings. The denim pattern is projected on.
Hello, Kansas City!
Stick to the agreed-upon choreography, please.
Peter partied all night with international bozo Ryan Lochte. And this voiceover was actually covered by my original payment.
I'm very impressed. I didn't know you skated.
Yeah, well, there's a lot you don't know about me. Peace!
Oh my God, are you okay?
Don't go on the ice, it's too slippery. I'll crawl back, don't watch me.
I became known as an up-and-comer with a mean left hook who farted every time he got punched in the stomach. By the second round, the entire front row had pink eye. But I was rising through the ranks and fighting bigger and better opponents. I fought Butterbean, then I fought Can't Believe It's Not Butterbean. I could barely tell the difference. I fought Sugar Ray Leonard Nimoy, who put a Vulcan nerve pinch on me. The fight was deemed highly illogical. I defeated Lennox Lewis in the news, Evander Sallyfield, and Roberto Duran Duran. I was supposed to fight George Foreman, but I only got George 3 men and a baby. There's a lot more puns, but this episode's only got a few minutes left. So finally, I got my shot at the title against the world champion, Marvelous Marvin Mrs. Maisel. I was outmatched, a no-name punk fighting the world champion. I fought my heart out. I dug deep and had a kick-ass song on my side. But we couldn't afford the song from the movie, so we used the sound effects from Nintendo Punch-Out.
What the
Body blow. Body blow. Uppercut. Uppercut. Body blow. Uppercut.
The swollen eyes weren't from the fight. There was a cat in the arena, and I was highly allergic. But I'd done it. The only fighter ever to go the distance with the champ. But in that moment, there was only one thing I could think about.
Peter, the Rothko exhibit at the museum is reopened. Are you busy last week?
She had nailed me. I was, in fact, free last week.
And we're back with Fox Celebrity Boxing with Mike Tyson and Carol Channing.
I tell you, Jim, how Carol Channing outlasted that barrage in the second round, we'll never know.
Come here, young man. I'm gonna bop you one.
She's getting beat.
No, she's getting mad.
Ah, you ain't so tough, young man. You got, you son of a bitch. You're going down, young man. You're going down.
I can't believe this. She keeps getting up. I'm so exhausted.
And the winner by technical knockout, weighing in at 67 pounds, Carol, put on your Sunday clothes, Channing.
Yeah. Up yours, young people. You and your rock and roll 8-track tapes.
I don't believe this. I just lost a $50 bet.
You know, Mike Tyson once beat up his wife. But there's nothing funny about that.
Take it off! I want to see if mine look right.
Well, Chris, we've looked all over town. Might as well check here. This is where dollar bills come to die.
Wait, Grandpa, look!
I don't believe it!
Oh no, now we'll never find it!
Hold on, I got an idea. Hey, can I turn off everything but the black lights?
Sure, I don't care about anything.
Cool.
Wow, this place is gross!
Yeah, the NBA All-Star game was in town last week.
There it is! I got it, Grandpa!
Attaboy! Happy birthday, grandson!